Hello student, in last class we have discussed Ohm's law, proof of Ohm's law. The parametric formula for resistance is L is equal to R is equal to ML, LE square A tau. Now today we will talk about the factor on which resistance or resistivity depends. Here for resistivity the formula will be M over L square tau. So, as we see that the resistivity is inversely proportional to N. This is electron density. It tells about the nature of metal. Resistivity is inversely proportional to electron density. Electron density is number of free electrons in per unit volume. If a metal has higher electron density, then it has low resistivity and it is inversely proportional to tau. Tau is mean relaxation time which increases resistivity is inversely proportional to tau. Tau is mean relaxation time. On increasing the temperature of a metallic conductor, its resistivity increases because mean relaxation time decreases. When we rise up the temperature of a metallic conductor, on increasing the temperature of a metallic conductor, tau decreases. So, resistance or resistivity increases. But when we talk about semiconductor, the nature of semiconductor is quite opposite to the metal. On increasing the temperature of semiconductor material, its resistivity decreases. Now, today we will do combination of resistors. Combination of resistors. As we have done in capacitor, there are two types of combination. One is series combination and other is parallel. So, there are two types of combination. One is series. In series combination, the resistor are joined like this. Suppose this is R1, R2, R3 and this whole combination is connected to a battery of potential difference V. In series combination, the current, the value of current in each resistor will be same, but potential difference across each resistor will be different. As we have seen from this figure, the total applied potential difference or the potential difference of battery will be equal to algebraic sum of potential across each resistor. So we know V is equal to IR. So IR, this is IR1, IR2, IR3. Here R is equivalent resistance. So, if we have some resistor and we want to find the maximum equivalent resistance, then we must combine all resistor in series. So, in series combination, the equivalent resistance R is equal to algebraic sum of all resistor connected in series. This is series combination. Now the second combination is parallel combination. Parallel combination. So consider we have three resistors connected in end to end like this by a battery of potential difference V. In parallel combination, this is the parallel combination of three resistors connected to a battery of potential difference V. In parallel combination, the current in each resistor will be different, but the potential difference across end of each resistor will be same as potential difference across the end of terminal of battery, because all resistors have same end, connected by the same end. So in this combination, total current I is given by I1 plus I2 plus I3, and we know I is equal to V over R. Here R is equivalent resistance. So this is 1 over R is equal to 1 over R1, 1 over R2, 1 over R3. This is equivalent resistance in parallel combination of resistor. So it was the parallel combination. Yesterday we have talked about Ohm's law, the condition in which Ohm's law fulfill. So there are two conditions for this law to obey. One is, if we plot a graph between I and V, it must be a straight line passing through origin. Strictly, it must be a straight line passing through origin. If a graph for any conductor is like this, or this, only this conductor obey Ohm's law, because if we plot graph between V and I, we get a straight line passing through origin. In all these three graphs, the conductor for which we have plot these graphs do not obey Ohm's law. In this graph, here we get a straight line, but it is not passing through origin. So it does not obey Ohm's law. And Ohm's law is for metallic conductor and for low value of current. The physical condition such as temperature must remain constant for obey Ohm's law. Always remember, Ohm's law is for metallic conductor and for low value of current, and the physical condition such as temperature must remain constant. Now we have electrical, another topic, electrical energy and power spent by a battery. Consider a resistor is connected through a battery of potential difference V. So let the work done by the battery in flowing charge Q through this resistor is given by W is equal to QV. As we know, Q is equal to IT, then it is VIT. This is the work done by the battery in flowing some charge or current in this resistor. So it is also called electrical energy or circuit. Now we can convert this formula into different parameter. As we know, V is equal to IR, so we can write E is equal to I square RT, or E is equal to V square upon R into T. These are the expression for electrical energy spent by the battery in the circuit. And if we want to calculate the power of circuit, if we know the power is P is equal to W over T, only remove T from this formula, you will get the formula for power. So, power P is equal to VI, I square R, or V square upon R. These are the formula for power.